All right. What we are talking with you, what we have been telling you in the lectures is the group 16 compounds, group 16 elements, in which we have told you oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium. And we are discussing the reactivity with oxygen. They combine with oxygen and form dioxides and trioxide. What they are forming? Dioxides.
Dioxides and trioxides.
But we are saying that these elements are forming CO2 and EO3. So the elements which we have here is sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium. Polonium is radioactive, so we don't talk much about that. And when we find sulfur is forming sulfur dioxide, selenium dioxide, tellurium dioxide, then sulfur trioxide and SCO3, TeO3. Sulfur, if you burn in oxygen, you will get sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide exists as discrete molecules. So what is NH2, NP4 is the outermost. That means this sulfur is having 3H2, 3P4. What it means? 3S and 3P. Sulfur is 3S and 3P. How many electrons you are?
Yes, sir.
1, 2, 3, 4. ठीक है? 4 हो गया?
Yes,
sir. The 3P is also there. 3D. Now the what will happen if excited state, if I write excited state, what is the excited state of this in these compounds? Excited state of this, what will be the result of that? Result of that, what is that? This is electron here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. This is our 3P, this is my 3D, and this is my 3S. This is my 3S. So, what is happening in SO2? If I consider the formation of SO2, in SO2, how many bonds sulfur is forming? Is sulfur excited? How many atoms it is bonded with? Two?
Two atoms.
Two atoms. So, two atoms. It is bonded with two atoms. And what is the hybridization then? What will be the hybridization in sulfur dioxide? What is the hybridization in sulfur dioxide?
Hybridization in sulfur dioxide is
it is sp2. See that? How I do that? How many atoms it is bonded? There are how many atoms? Two atoms?
Yes, sir.
Two atoms. And after bonding with the two atoms, how many lone pairs? How many lone pairs are there on the sulfur? You have a lone pair?
You will have one lone. One lone pair.
Two plus one is three, therefore it is sp2. This is only a trick. Otherwise, we can see here also. sp2 with one lone pair, which is gone. This is sp2 and one lone pair. Now, what is left? What is left in the sulfur? You have a electron in the p pi.
P pi, yes, sir.
This is a p pi. And there's a DPI also. There's a DPI.
Yes, sir.
The sulfur. This is my sulfur. It is combining with oxygen. Then what it will do? Oxygen. What oxygen has? What is in the oxygen?
Also has lone pair of electrons.
Oxygen also has p pi. Is oxygen has two electrons, in the p pi. Oxygen has two electrons in the p pi. Oxygen doesn't have d. Does it have d?
No, sir.
No, oxygen doesn't have d. If I say this is my oxygen, 2s2p, 2s2p. How many electrons are there? There are, you can see there are two lone pairs of electrons and two electrons here. So if oxygen forms one bond, it has one electron in the where p pi.
Okay.
Can you see oxygen? Oxygen is 2s, 2p, 4. This
yes,
is oxygen. Sir. What it means? 2s. Let me draw it because there is something interesting here. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is oxygen. How many?
Yes, sir.
Two lone pairs. And two electrons. When oxygen forms one bond with sulfur, sp2 hybridized, and this one is p, sp2p. I'm saying sp2p, this is one bond. Okay? Similarly, this is another oxygen. This is also forming sp2p, sulfur. Okay? I'm talking of sulfur.
Okay.
But there is a one electron. This is left in the p pi. Okay, p pi of the oxygen. Here there is one electron and sulfur can use. Sulfur has which one? Sulfur has got this p pi. Can you see? Important. Where is sulfur? This is sulfur. This is p pi and this is d pi. Sulfur has got one p pi and one d pi. So what it can do, then it can form with oxygen, p pi bond, and another one is d pi p pi bond. That is a multiple bond which you are seeing in the surface of silver is like this.
Okay.
Did I draw the correct structure of SO2?
Yes.
How do you draw SO2 then? What do you draw? SO2 and this. This is the right structure of this?
Yes, sir.
But we said sp2
hybridization.
This is a little bit tricky. I mean, a little bit of difficult, so I have to show it. And you have p pi 1 p pi bond and 1 d pi p pi bond. That is why there are double bonds in the sulfur. You can see with the lone pair of electrons. And can there be resonance here? Tell me, can there be resonance?
In resonance.
What happens? I can say like this. Dekho.
Sir, it has two resonance structures, but they will be equal.
What I am saying, there is a lone pair. this, if I say this is the sulfur, if I say that this is P pi, P pi, then this is D pi, P pi. So we can have another one. What is that? This can be D pi, P pi, and this can be P pi, P pi. Because this is the story here. Yeah, you see, one electron is in the P and one is in the D. So P pi, D pi bonding is there. D pi bond, as the size increases, the effective overlap becomes less. They have become more weaker. Okay. But that is the way sulfur dioxide exists. And it has bent angular structure, it is bent. This is special in this. Some question has been given on this. Bent angular structure it has, and it has a high dipole moment. Dipole moment value 1.63 dy. It has a dipole moment, student. As you can see, oxygen is more electronegative than sulfur. And the bond angle is 119.5 degree. Bond angle is, and sp2 hybridized is a planar molecule with 120 degree, but there is a lone pair of electrons, so the bond angle is 119.5 degree. It exists as discrete molecules. So what type of forces will be there in this when it is discrete? What type of forces of attraction are there? Forces, van der Waal forces. That is why it is gas. No? It is SO2 is gas. Discrete molecules have van der Waal forces.
Okay.
These are weak forces. Discrete. So as you will go, what you are forming? SiEO2, SiO2, and this selenium dioxide is there, and you can see that it can exist in the solid form. SeO2, selenium oxide. In gas phase it is linear, but in forms linear chain form of SeO2. In solid form linear chain.
Okay.
Linear chain. So the what happens, more than one SiO2 unit, they link together. Whenever there is a chain, what will happen? The structure will become bigger, and then it becomes a solid. You know, chain, I'm saying chain. It is not discrete. Discrete molecules like SO2, CO2, they are always gases. This question has been asked. Discrete molecules will have weak van der Waal force of attraction. But if there is a chain, if there is a polymeric structure, then what happened? P4, white phosphorus P4, and then you are coming to another form, polymeric. When chains or polymers are formed, then its structure becomes bigger and bigger, and they will become solids and of higher melting points. And that is why, what is the reason for that? Now everything has to be thought. Reason: SeO2 selenium dioxide is white crystalline solid.
Okay.
Question was given, SO2 is gas and SeO2 is solid, white crystalline solid. What you said, SO2 gas, SeO2 white crystalline solid. It is a solid because it forms linear chain structure,
polymer structure. Yes,
chain. There will be more than one units of SeO2. They will link together. What is the reason for that? Now every time we are giving reason, that is our problem of inorganic chemistry. I can pass it in seconds and it's over, course is over, no issue. But if I start asking questions which are coming in the paper, then I have to think about it. I cannot write anything. See, there is a reason for everything. That's what I'm saying. But I told you that right from the beginning, P-Log is a big chapter, maximum marks it has. And questions will be there, you can easily score. Or if you pass time in it, it's zero marks. But you, because we don't know, we have to know why. And I have shown you the what will happen. The multiple bond formation tendency will decrease down the group because the size is becoming bigger. When the size becomes bigger, what happens? Size become bigger. You know now. Size increasing. Tell me. Down the group.
Yes, sir.
Then
yes, sir, sir.
Type of bonds will be difficult to form.
Difficult to make. So the multiple bond formation decreases.
Why? Because the overlap not effective. अरे नजदीक होंगे तो ओवरलैप करेंगे ना एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स.
यस सर.
दे आर वेरी बिगर फार अवे. हाउ दे कैन शेक हैंड्स विद ईच अदर. हाउ दे कैन कम टुगेदर. हाउ दे कैन ओवरलैप. इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. सो दैट इज द रीजन यू नो द मल्टीपल बॉन्ड टेंडेंसी विल कीप ऑन डिक्रीजिंग एंड देयर मे फॉर्म सम लीनियर चेंज और समथिंग लाइक दैट. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू हैपन एंड दीज यूनिट्स विल बी देयर. तो व्हाट विल हैपन. SO2 has a non-planar structure. TO2, PO2 are non-volatile crystalline ionic solids. Each one of these exists in two crystalline form. TeO2 is solid state, has layered structure. Layered structure. TeO2 also has a layered structure, I'm saying. So, okay, I put it here. TeO2, this has got a layered structure. The multiple bond tendency will decrease. The size is increasing. Size they will be existing in crystalline solid forms, crystalline form. So there will be many TeO4 units. They are joining together. So we could understand something about this SO2 and this. So this part is clear. Huh? Okay.
Yes, sir.
But this part was a little bit difficult. That's why I have to take some time here. All right. I don't need this. Yeah. Oh, I got it. Everything we have to think. Answers come when we start thinking. Some small questions are asked, that's all, everywhere. Otherwise it seems there is no question in inorganic chemistry. What question I will ask? I'm not going to ask you to write an equation. All this is based on basic concepts, understanding. Okay. When I was not thinking, I know nothing about what chemistry is all about. It's just the rattebaji. Hai. Abhi 90% student thinking it is rattebaji. What I will do rattebaji? Because they don't know anything. When I start understanding the basic things, then I will understand the chemistry. They can't write the Lewis structure. They can't write the hybridization. They don't know which what overlaps are taking place. What answer they will give? Tell me what chemistry you are learning. Rattebaji. How much rattebaji I can do? Then it becomes senseless. Everything is senseless. When I write on the board three lines, when I start explaining it, it is many pages. That's what I'm saying. The NCERT book is like this, that every line has a meaning. When you start explaining it, you will need lot of information. What type of orbitals are there? What is the size of the atom? All these things come there. What type of bonds are formed? You can see what is happening. Of hybridization is taking place. All right, we could understand something. I can understand something on this. Further, you see that what is happening. If I see you are having EO2, okay? This way you got it everything. Mainly focus was on sulfur dioxide because that is important.
Okay.
Now I am saying EO3. Now what is the story? What game is going to happen here? What is the oxidation number of E here? I am talking of now oxidation number. nobody student even don't know what is oxidation number. There are so many things we are answering based on that. Entire chemistry I am trying on redox reaction. You see, so such an important topic. What will be the result of that, student? What will be the result of that? What is the oxidation number of E here? This is minus 2, plus 4. And
plus
here,
four.
Plus 6.
Plus 6.
So what it shows to me, you know that these are plus 4. And plus 4 means they can go to lower states. Plus
yes,
6
sir.
Means they can go to lower states.
Lower states.
If they can go to lower states, then what they are acting as, what they are acting as, they are undergoing reduction.
Reduction. So they are acting as oxidizing agents.
Some, and they have certain reducing as well as oxidizing properties.
Okay.
And EO2 here plus 4 to plus 6, if they go, what will happen?
Oxidation.
No, they are oxidized. Then what they can do? They can be reducing.
Okay.
You know, SO2 acts as a reducing agent. In chemistry lab, you are doing sulfur dioxide. It changes the color. Sulfur dioxide. We have studied the reaction of SO2. So here plus 4 to plus 6 are possible, and plus 6 to plus 4 are also possible. And therefore, what is going to happen? That there can be oxidizing as well as reducing property, whereas sulfur is more stable in plus 4. So SO2, it is more stable in plus 4. So what will happen? If you have SO3, this is plus 6. And SO2 is plus 4. If this takes place, it is gaining electron. It is gaining electron.
Okay.
So plus 6 oxidation states, you already said oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium. Plus 6 oxidation state become less stable down the group, and plus 4 becomes more stable.
Yes, sir. More stable.
Down the group. They become more acceptable down the group. Therefore, if I say the SO3, what will happen in SO3? You know, SOO3. What is sulfur? You are saying is how many? 3S2, 3P4. 3H2, 3P4, 6 electrons, 3. 3 are there, then you can have more. So what is the result of this? Sometimes they show it like this.
Mm-hmm.
So it is a resonance hybrid. It is a resonance hybrid. Resonance hybrid. All these bond lengths will be equal. So there will be p pi, and p pi, d pi bonds, which will be there in SO3. So considering that, why I said like this, there's that oxygen is a double bond here, sulfur, this is 2, 4, 6 electrons. Okay? 2, 4, 6.
Okay.
So the result is, but since there are p pi, and p pi, d pi. They can exchange in three ways. There will be three possibilities.
Yes, sir.
Three resonance structures of SO3. This is all about the oxides. We may see something more later on. Now I'm coming to the halides. Halides. They are forming different type of halides. There are something like O2F2, S2F2. Also known Se2Cl2, Se2Br2. These are halides. So we know about them. O2F2. Again, if I take two common OF, something like that. So this type of halides are there. Then you have OF2. Then you have SF2. Se. You have Se. Cl2, all these are that stable. They are not that stable. But few dihalides are known in the book. They will mention somewhere, which are known. TeCl2. The lower oxidation states becoming less in certain cases. Okay. Whatever exists, OF2 is known, but here the oxidation number of oxygen is plus, you know, because fluorine is a strongly oxidizing.
Strong oxidizing agent.
Tetrahalides, SFS is well known, SCl4 is known, and you have SeF4 is known, then you have TeF4, this is also known. Something like these compounds are known, and among the hexafluoride, SF6 is very well known. SeF6 is known. So there is a variety of halides, hexahalides. You have seen hexahalides, and stability of hexafluorides, SeF6. TeF6. This is the order of the stability of hexafluoride. What is the this compound is? This question was there. This question. Not all the questions are that big, but this question was there. You can see that what is happening. This is very, very stable. This is quite stable molecule. Sulfur hexafluoride is very stable. What is the reason for that was asked? And it is chemically inert. Chemically inert. SF6 question. SF6, I am saying, is chemically inert. It is not reacting, even not hydrolyzed. Not hydrolyzed. This question was given in the paper. What is the reason?
Sir, in SF6, sulfur is surrounded by 6 fluorine atoms. Mm. So, maybe because this fluorine atoms protect the sulfur from the attack of reagents. So, it is chemically inert, steric reasons. Steric reasons.
So, it is chemically inert. 6 fluorine atoms protect sulfur atoms from attack by reagents. And even those reactions which are thermodynamically possible, like hydrolysis, also do not take place. Actually, you will see that fluorine is small in size. And this molecule is symmetric. Sulfur hexafluoride.
Okay.
And therefore, it's quite stable molecule. It is not interested to react. And these fluorines are protecting the sulfur. Because the fluorine are small in size. So they are protecting the sulfur very well. But if, as you go down the group, what will happen? This is not hydrolyzed. This is not hydrolyzed, student. This question. Whereas other, if I take SeF6, this is hydrolyzed.
Okay.
Hydrolysis means what? What mean by water has to attack? Where is water? This is water. This has to attack the sulfur.
Yes, sir.
Then only hydrolysis will take place. And if the size is bigger, then steric hindrance is less. With increase in size, what will happen? Size of the element E. Steric hindrance will decrease.
Okay. Okay.
And then hydrolysis will take place. SF6 is not hydrolyzed, but SeF6 is hydrolyzed. This question was given. Okay. And what is the shape of the octahedral?
Octahedral.
And these are exceptionally stable. SF6 is exceptionally stable for steric reasons. The fluorines are protecting. If I see the other halides, let me see other halides. What other halides are there? Tetrahalides. SF4. Here, these are the tetrahalides. What we are seeing, you are forming EX6, EX4, and EX2. And tetrafluoride, if I see, what will happen in the tetrafluoride? SF4. SF4 is tetrahalides. How many?
Tetrahalide.
What is the shape of this tetrahalide has been asked?
Tetrahalide is trigonal bipyramidal.
Trigonal bipyramidal. What is sulfur? What, how we draw the sulfur? 3s, 3p, 3d. 4, what was in here? There were 2 electrons. 1, 2, 3, and 1 here. What is the hybridization? What is a hybridization? Important question.
SF4 sp3d.
sp3d. Hybridization is sp3. sp3d, but there is a lone pair of electron. What is the shape of this has been asked? What is the shape of SF4 has been asked in the exam? Question. I got it. I read the question.
Okay.
The hexafluorides are very important question in terms of the shape of this. What is the shape of this? What is the shape of this? This is an important question. Okay. This question has been asked few times, I'm telling you. Something is there. What is there? What shape you are telling? For SF4.
For SF4, it will be trigonal bipyramidal.
That is given by hybridization, but that is not the shape of this. Why? Because you can see the hybridization is sp3d. If I say sp3d, what happens in sp3d?
Seesaw.
Let me see. This is what is your sp3d?
Yes, sir. Wait. Yes, sir.
But what is the story here? It has got how many? SF4. It is not SF5. It is SF4. Student, let me see. There is some. Some student did a lot of mistake here again. SF4, how many atoms? Four?
Four atoms.
Then where will you put four atoms? That is the story now. Will the shape will be like that? You have lone pair of electron does not come in the shape when I say the shape. Hybridization is sp3d, okay. Hybridization is sp3d, students. Bond pairs 4, lone pair 1, total 5. And I say sp3d. That is was my trick.
Yes, sir.
4 sp3, 5 sp3d, 6 sp3d2.
D2, yes, sir.
Okay. So we could learn something. But the story is now what will be the shape of this? This is an important question. Unless we give a wrong answer. Important question. Where will I put a lone pair of electron? This you can put at a equatorial position. Now, what is the shape looking like? Tell me. What is the shape known as? You have read this. Chemical bonding chapter also 11th. I said this question was very important. C, what do they call it? Seesaw?
Seesaw geometry.
Seesaw. That is why I said this is an important question. Students are giving wrong answer.
Yes, sir.
This seesaw. Seesaw. Okay, seesaw. There's a lone pair of electrons. This will become little bit of distorted. This will repel now. This will repel and will show some distortion. This will push them little bit on the back side. On the back side. So these tetrafluorides will have this type of shape. Students, what type of shape tetrafluorides are expected? And hexafluorides are?
Hexafluorides are octahedral.
SP3, D2, and
D2, and octahedral.
This question sometimes will be asked to the students. Therefore, this is clear. Okay, all questions have been discussed. These questions have been asked in the paper. All questions are these. But I am talking with you, question, answer, question, answer. Otherwise, we can easily read it. No issue, no problem. They will become questions in the paper. Oh, got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we are coming to, we have to think before we answer anything, students. Now we have to see what questions can be there. Now I'm coming to the dioxygen. Dioxygen. What is dioxygen? O2 gas is so well known to you. So well known to you. Dioxygen is so well known to you. And it is present in air also. Dioxygen is present in the air also, which you can see that it is present in the air also. Is it present in the air? Yes. How much? You already know. So what we are saying, preparation. I have just written only one line. By heating oxygen containing salts such as chlorates, nitrates, and permanganates. Chlorates, can you tell me the name of any chlorate which is important and used?
Chlorate, KClO3 is a chlorate.
KClO3 is a chlorate. I said chlorates, nitrates, and permanganates. You have to heat it. But reaction will be slow. But you know what catalyst is added here. Very important. What catalyst is added here to get oxygen?
KCl plus.
Name of the catalyst. Student, question is always something different. But you see, they have given, I am saying chlorate, but then they will say ki, which catalyst has been used.
MnO2.
MnO2. If you add this, a pinch of only pinch of this, the reaction becomes very fast. So this is an important point. Second important point, I'm saying. These are the points to be discussed. Second important point. What we are saying? Thermal decomposition. Thermal decomposition. What is the thermal decomposition?
We have by heating. Decomposition by heating.
But which oxides will be easier to decompose? You know that in metallurgy there is a Allingham diagram, metallurgy. In the chapter of metallurgy, what do? We convert metal into oxides and oxides are reduced. You know, carbon is the most easiest reducing agent, which is called smelting in the metallurgy chapter, extraction of metals from their ores. But certain oxides will decompose. Those oxides are metals which are low in electrochemical sealing. Low in electrochemical sealing. See the story? That is a Gibbs free energy. Low in electrochemical sealing. The reaction Gibbs free energy is negative. The reaction takes place. Gibbs free energy negative. The reaction takes place. All these concepts are used. So, for example, if you have mercury oxide, you don't need carbon for this. You have to heat it. Heat it, student, okay. And it will dissociate. What will you get? What will you get? This is my solid. And mercury, you know, is a liquid at room temperature. Mercury is a liquid at room temperature. It will dissociate. So the reaction is favorable. The reaction is favorable. The Gibbs free energy change for this is negative, student. Negative, it will take place. It will take place. So the formation of oxide and decomposition of the oxides, they are low in electrochemical series. They are low in electro. Similarly, the lead oxide, lead also dissociates. The silver also Ag2O. It on heating. What will happen? It will dissociate to give silver and oxygen gas. Silver and oxygen gas. So you have 2 Ag2, so you can have 4 Ag. So here you are getting silver. These are oxygen gases being produced in these oxygen gases. And further, on large scale, you know, large scale, the best water. If you have water, what you can do? Electrolytic decomposition of water.
Okay.
What will happen? What will come at cathode? What will come at anode? What will come at cathode? What will come at anode? That is the question. Anode and cathode.
Cathode, anode. Anode will be oxygen, and cathode will be hydrogen.
How? Cathode will be?
Cathode will be hydrogen, and anode will be oxygen.
You have H plus and OH minus.
OH minus.
So H plus will get reduced. H plus will get reduced. This will get oxidized. Oxidized, students. So what you are getting? Hydrogen at the cathode. What you are getting? And oxygen at the?
At anode.
Oxygen at the anode. What will happen? OH and H2O. So you can see that. And also you can get it from air. How from you will get oxygen from the air? What do we do to the air? You have so much oxygen in the air. What is that? What do you call as liquefaction? Air.
Okay.
And then what will decrease the temperature, decrease, and increase the pressure. Then at critical temperature, what happens? Liquefaction. Then what do you do? Fractional distillation. So it is possible.
Okay.
All these are some of the ways we can look at the type of questions which can be. The question can be anything in any competition also. You don't expect that there is a limit of the questions. But it is based on our understanding of the chemistry. Basic thing. I'm only talking about basic chemistry. I'm only talking of the basic fundamentals which we have to learn. Rest is all in the book. You can do whatever cramming or mugging. Nobody is stopping any student. But it is better to understand the things. So we know. He is not asking water decomposition. What is he asking? At which cathode, at which electrode oxygen is liberated? Now here the trouble starts. Question is not that I know water can be decomposed. He will not ask that question. Then he will ask at which electrode oxygen is liberated when it is electrolyzed. That the question begins. So students are confused. Anode or cathode. Here the problem is that unless you have thought about it, unless you understand it, how you can answer? There is no mugging now. Got my point? So we know what we are doing. Okay, when I talk the properties of this, what I am discussing, certain preparation and properties. Oxygen, you know, is very reacting with almost metals and non-metals also. In the earth crust, you know, minerals, oxides, how many oxides? Oh, so many metals are carbon oxide. You are aware of that. So oxygen has got 3 isotopes, O16, O17, O18. And in how much, there is enough of oxygen dissolved in water also, so that aquatic life can live. That we are aware. Aquatic life also needs oxygen, but they need much less than what we have. So it dissolves in water. And what is the story? It will react with all metals. Almost okay. Metals it will react. It will react with metals? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
For example, if I have calcium, what will happen? Oxygen will react with this.
Yes, sir.
Getting oxides. You are getting oxides. It is a non-metal. Non-metal is reacting. Phosphorus, white phosphorus, I told you, is chemiluminescent. P4O10. It will burn in oxygen. And you know, CH4 gas and O2, what happens? But you are getting CO2, H2O, and a lot of energy heat. The fuels, here, organic fuels, which you are using. We have to balance that equation. You can balance this
No problem. CO2 H2O and heat. So 2H2O.
So what do we find? It can react, but it may need some initiation. Now you got my point. Reaction is not that immediately it is reacting with everything. Some energy requirements are there, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But gold and platinum are not reacting. Gold and platinum are not reacting with oxygen. So questions can be like this: which metals are not reacting with oxygen? Gold, platinum, they are not reacting with oxygen.
Okay.
Few metals are there. And noble gases also. Noble gases, some amount is present in the atmosphere also. Argon. They are not reacting with oxygen. And these reactions are usually exothermic. But you have seen exothermic. So they will liberate large amount of heat. But we said, for initiation is required. Initiation means some energy requirement is there. Why the energy requirement is there? Tell me. Because oxygen is what? What is the structure of oxygen? How do you draw oxygen? Lewis structure. I said draw the Lewis structure. What you have done? How many? 6 electrons?
Is it yes, sir. Because bond dissociation enthalpy of oxygen is very high.
493.4 kilojoule per mole is a double bond. 493. So this is energy to react. Unless it will break, it will not react. So we have to supply energy. Initiation is required. Initiation is required in order to react this. These are some of the things which we have told you about the oxygen. And as I said, oxygen is forming oxides. Oxides. What is oxygen forming, student? Oxides. And the oxides will be acidic or basic or amphoteric. Three possibilities are there. Oxides. Oxides can be acidic, basic. There can be a question on that. What question I'm saying? Oxides. But just I will take. Whatever is important, I will tell you. Then rest we have nothing to do with it. Oxides, now oxides. What question has been given? It is forming oxide with metal. It is forming oxide with non-metals.
Yes, sir.
Okay, pardon. Okay. What question can be there on oxides?
They can all be of three types.
Okay. Now we are saying what I am saying. Oxides. There are metallic oxides and there are non-metallic oxides.
Yes, sir.
I am dividing in two parts. Give me example of metallic oxide. You are saying okay, CaO, okay, calcium oxide,
sodium oxide,
or so many, all metal and oxygen, you are saying. And you are saying give me non-metallic oxides.
CO2.
Okay, CO2.
NO2.
NO2, okay. Nitrogen, they are non-metal. What non-metal? You have sulfur.
SO2.
You have phosphorus.
PO4.
Okay. Now, the only thing is, metallic oxides will be acidic or basic?
Metallic oxides will be basic.
This is the point. This is the question. Metallic oxides are basic, you are saying. And non-metallic oxides are?
Acidic.
Acidic. Acidic in character. How, on what basis you say non-metallic oxides are acidic, metallic oxides are basic? How will you say metallic oxides are basic? When you will dissolve in water, what will happen?
When we dissolve in water, metallic oxide will form bases.
Bases. And these will form?
Acids.
Acids. So, when you dissolve in water, it depends what type of acid or bases are produced. You are getting hydroxide ion or acidic. And there will be some neutral like CO, NO. These are neutral oxides. Okay? Neutral yes, oxides. Sir. But the most important point is amphoteric oxide. The question has been asked on this. Give an example of amphoteric oxide, student, this question.
Example is aluminium, Al2O3.
Okay. So, this is a story. And you have to give a reactions in the paper. When I say it is amphoteric, if it is an acid, you will react with the base. What base? Take sodium hydroxide.
Okay.
If it is a base, then you react
with HCl, acid.
And then you write the reaction.
Okay.
Then you should go to that direction. Here I have given you two reactions. That was a question. See, these are the two reactions. This question has been asked. Al2O3 is amphoteric. And acid with HCl, you can see the formation. And with sodium hydroxide, you can see the formation. So, amphoteric oxides will be there. We should know that the acidic, basic, amphoteric and neutral oxides. Got it?
Yes, sir.
All right, we end up this lecture here, and there were so many important questions which were discussed. We'll continue further in our next classes. After the group is finished, we'll go to the group 17 and see whatever is important and whatever questions are possible will be discussed in every lecture.
Okay,
then good night.
Sir, wo papa ko aapse kuch baat karni thi. So when are you free?
कोई बात नहीं तुम मेरे को ना 9 बजे के बाद कर लेना.
ओके सर.
ऑलराइट.
ओके. ठीक है. थैंक यू सर. यस सर. थैंक यू सर.
ऑलराइट.
थैंक यू सर.